We're kicking off Okinawa Week here on K212 with another brand new edition of Sam Choi's in the Kitchen. I'm John Veneri. This is Chef Sam Choi.
And we're going to be meeting Grant Murata, and he knows a lot about Okinawan cuisine.
Okay. There he is.
Nice job.
How are you, sir?
Good to see you.
Mensore means irashaimase, you know.
Ah, you know, could you show us around?
Mensore.
Minnesota, I know that place. I've been there many times in the winter. Cold over there, Minnesota.
Wow, what is this place?
This is our newly refurbished museum. And this is where you can find out about where everything started. So, you know, the Okinawans immigrated to Hawaii in 1900, so it's very easy to trace. So we have these exhibits here about how plantation life was for the Okinawans. Mm-hmm. And that guy right there in the middle, Toyama Kyuzo, Kyuzo Toyama, he's said to be the father of Okinawan immigration. He went to great lengths to let the Okinawans get the chance to immigrate to Hawaii because immigration from Japan came early. Mm. But they didn't think Uchinanchus were Okinawans were sophisticated enough. So this is the man.
Can you tell me a little bit about the Hawaii United Okinawa Association?
So, after the immigration, you know, they had to go through the ravages of World War II.
Right.
And after World War II finished, finally in 1951, all of the Okinawan clubs decided to get together and start a organization that encompasses everybody. And then the Hawaii United Okinawa Association was born.
Hey, look, pigs from the sea. What's all that about?
After the war finished, Okinawa was decimated and their staple pigs were all gone. So these seven men, after hearing that Okinawa had no pigs already, decided to go to the mainland, buy 550 piglets, and put them on a boat, and take them to Okinawa. And in Okinawa, they saw this boat come, and all of these pigs get off, and then that's why they use the phrase, pigs from the sea. This is a success story.
Wow.
And now, you know, they helped Okinawans refurbish their stock, and from that stock there are several generations of pigs there, you know.
So I'm thinking all those pigs, pork, food.
Let's go to the kitchen.
Follow me.
Well, I see a lot of stuff out here. Let's go ahead and get started. The first dish that we're gonna do is the
OMUKUJI ANDAGI.
Bingo. What ingredients do we have?
So we have beni imo,
or Okinawan.
Some people call it Okinawan sweet potato, but actually what I found out is Okinawans borrowed this from the Filipinos.
Really?
So they call ube.
Ube.
Yeah.
We have OMUKUJI. OMUKUJI is a type of potato starch. This is produced in Okinawa. And then yukishio, the Okinawan sea salt.
Okay.
It's kind of like that Kauai salt.
Yeah.
So okay. When I can't get that, I use that Kauai salt from Kauai.
And you have chives.
Oh
you're
chives.
Spilling already.
Sorry.
Sorry, Chef. We're so short. Sorry. Okay, what's first?
What we should do first is, can I have you mash this up?
Okay.
Okay. And I'm going to cut the chives.
Goes in there.
Yeah.
How mashed do you want this?
As much as you can.
Okay, Chef, how's that look?
Oh, that looks good.
All of it, right?
Yeah.
All the salt too?
Yep.
Okay, we're missing some salt though.
That's okay. So the word, you hear the word andagi, what that automatic tells you is, you think about that round, sweet donut stuff that you eat at the festival, right?
Yep.
But andagi actually means, all it means is tempura in Okinawan, the Okinawan language. So this is gonna be not a sweet dish, but as you can see, it's gonna be a savory dish.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay, so now.
Oh, look at that.
Good job.
Okay.
I like the beginning of the story about unagi. I mean, the sweet potato.
Yeah, ube.
Ube, yeah.
Okay, now I'm just gonna add this in here.
Okay.
This.
Wow, that's amazing.
I guess it's time to fry.
Okay. Let's put this aside.
I want everybody to get a chance. Okay. Think about this much, maybe. Roll it in your hand.
Okay.
Smash it down like this.
Okay. Oh, it immediately changes color too.
Yeah.
Oh, this is just like Play-Doh.
Yeah.
I was about to say, it looks like it. Like that?
Yeah.
Oh, John, y'all look nice, John. You played a lot of peido when you're young, eh?
I did. I still do.
Come on, keep on going. Let's take two more.
Not just one.
Hey, you're schlucking, you guys.
I love it.
Yeah, John likes that.
I don't mind getting scolded.
Oh, thank you.
He scolds me a lot.
Who does?
Him.
Yeah, right.
Really? I never see it on
camera.
Okay,
so this, the first one you put in started to pop to
yeah,
the top.
Yeah, so what? Let's let them all come to the top.
Okay.
And wait until they get a little brown color. Now.
We gotta wait till they get too much already.
Yeah, well, we don't have to fry them all, right?
I'm hungry.
It smells good, I think, you know, because you said it's savory and the green onions in there.
So this would be eaten just as it is, like that, without any dipping sauce or anything.
And you know, because it's called umukuji tempura. Yeah. Umukuji is talking about this thing.
The flour.
So you can use any kind of sweet potato, even the yellow sweet potato.
Oh, no kidding. Oh.
You don't have to use ube or what we call over here, Okinawan sweet potato. But basically, that's the dish. We're gonna put it in here to suck up the oil.
Yeah.
And then later we'll plate it up. And
so you could potentially pull it out now, but we're gonna turn it over a couple times?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, I think we can pull them out.
I'm being careful, because they still stick a little bit.
Yeah. You can take them two out like that. How's the other one sticking together?
Yeah, a little bit.
There we go. It kind of looks like a, you know, a cookie just coming out of the oven. You know, then you let it sit and it gets nice and thick, you know?
Umukuji.
Andagi.
Andagi.
Umukuji andagi.
First dish, pal.
First dish, pal.
Chef Grant, what are we making next?
We're going to make Okinawa yakisoba.
Okay.
Oh, yakisoba.
Why is it called Okinawa yakisoba? Because we're going to use the Okinawa soba noodles.
Oh, very nice.
And that's this.
Yeah. Yeah, so we use these noodles. I really believe that this sun noodle product is better than Okinawa itself.
That's really?
What I love. Yeah.
What is the difference between these noodles and say?
Well, in Japan, soba is made from buckwheat.
Right.
Soba is buckwheat.
Okay.
But for some reason, in the early 1900s, they started to serve this type of noodle and they called it Okinawa soba.
Okinawa
so in
soba.
Okinawa, this is what is considered soba. Uh-huh.
Okay. Okay, what's first?
Put the spam and the kamaboko inside.
You don't put no oil, nothing.
I just put...
Oh, you got a little oil, sorry.
Very good.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Kamaboko, stir them around. Next one goes in is carrot.
John, thank you for cooking, John.
I don't mind, I'm learning.
Okay, let's put the carrots in.
Nice.
Give it a good stir.
You know what? Okay.
$2.
Put the $1 in.
Is it one or two?
$2.
Okay.
One went in, the second buck coming up.
Want to stir fry the hard for the part first.
You don't have no dashi, no nothing yet, huh?
Not yet.
Is there a reason why, or just?
That's just the way I do it.
Okay, well, your way is going to be like our million people watching
this.
Yeah,
a little bit salt.
Just a little bit of salt.
A little bit of salt.
The way you do it is the way our viewers will likely do it. Okay?
Okay, let's put some, why don't we put some of the black pepper?
Black pepper.
Okay, that's good. Yeah. Put the moyashi, the bean sprout. Bean sprout.
All of it?
All of it.
Yeah, put them all.
Okay.
Oh, sprinkle the dashi, that's a good idea.
So, the recipe says 1 teaspoon of tondashi, but I don't think we need that much. Now we're gonna put the yakisoba. Now we're gonna do the wake stuff.
The wake.
I gotta do it with the other hand.
Stand back, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Good job, John. Get him, man.
Get him. You taught him well.
No, he...
Green onions.
Green onions.
Still no liquid other than the oil.
No liquid.
This smells so good. A little bit more dashi.
A little bit more dashi, okay?
That looks good.
Peppers come in all shapes, sizes, and colors.
Many recipes call for them to be skinless. Why? Because they cook more evenly and taste better too, because the skins tend to have a bitter aftertaste.
The traditional way, which we'll try with these poblanos, is on the stovetop, burnt on all sides. When they're sufficiently blackened, place them in a bowl and cover to allow the steam to soften the skins. A few minutes later, the peppers are cool and ready to peel with a spoon. Now you can slice open and remove the seeds. Unlike other peppers, poblanos have a hard cluster of seeds that needs to be cut out. With bell and sweet peppers, cut and clean first. Brush with olive oil. Broil for 15 minutes. Cool and peel with a spoon. If you're not eating right away, store in a jar with olive oil. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
Little bit of that oyster sauce.
So Grant, honestly, how many times have you guys done this at festivals?
Huh? I know they make it at festivals, but they don't make it this way. But
they don't make it, this is your way.
They put a little bit different things in my thing. And they're gonna splash them with a bit of shoyu.
Asian gold from Aloha Shoyu.
Yes. Okay, time for the shoyu.
Shoyu up.
Shoyu up, little dog.
About how much? Okay, you do it. But I still want to know about how much you're putting in. About a tablespoon?
Half a teaspoon.
Oh, come on, you've got to mix them up.
Oh, that looks nice. Wow.
Let's turn off that
burner.
And then put them on that plate.
Now, let me ask you this. Who would not want to eat that? That is so good. John.
I want some.
Make some for your wife for dinner tonight. I boiled the noodles in water for a little while, maybe roughly about a minute, maybe.
Okay.
And what I do is I bring the water to a boil. As soon as you put the water in, of course, the temperature goes down.
Yeah.
So I just leave it in long enough for the temperature to come up again and boil, and then turn it off.
And you throw them in a colander.
Because if you boil for too long, then it's going to be all mushy, right?
Yeah.
So this should be very good right now.
This is the Okinawan Yakisoba. Chef Grant,
yes.
You can relax, although you're going to help us.
Okay.
Uncle Sam, it's our turn. What are you making?
Well, we're doing our famous Okinawan dish.
Our famous
Goya Champuru.
Yeah. There we go, Goya Champuru.
Goya Champuru.
Okay, so tell me the ingredients that we're using first.
Okay, well, we got tofu.
Tofu that we've been pressing.
Right, we pressed it so that, you know, get all the liquid out, most of the liquid. You're not going to cut this, you're going to hand break this. I'm going to have Chef Grant do that.
We got tofu, what else we got?
Bitter melon.
Goya.
Yeah. We got Goya.
That's what it's called?
Goya.
Okay, so we got the bitter melon, we got the tofu, we got eggs, we got some cut up pork belly. We have pepper and we have aloha shoyu. But we also have bok choy. Go ahead, give it a tug. Would you mind showing the camera what it is? Go ahead and show our viewers. We have
Pakuang.
Okay. You gotta use that. Well, so he has to use this somehow.
Go ahead.
Okay, and
A1 Yatsumizuke.
This is actually my
Matsura
favorite.
Matsura family. Nice Okinawan family make that.
Nice Okinawan family. Hey.
Say bye.
Bye.
This is perfect. So this is a nice complement to our dishes.
Get ready. So what do you want me to do?
He's going to break the tofu and put that in there. We brown the tofu first. That's important. And if you take notice, Grant is breaking it by hand. We're not cutting it. No. Just let it brown up. Try not to, break it up when you're stirring.
When I'm stirring it?
Yeah. Right. Let it sit there real nice. And we're using firm. You can go medium firm or firm. We're using firm. And if you take notice, if you had water in there, thank you very much, Grant.
It's going to pop all over
me
for one.
Then after we do this, we're going to take this out, push it up to one corner, and add the pork belly.
Right into it, okay.
Yeah, just to kind of like all the flavor. Then after the pork belly, then we'll add the beautiful bitter melon.
At what point will you know that this is done?
Well, when it starts to get brown.
All over, yeah. So we got to move it around a little bit then.
Well, just let it sit for now, So we have our dashi there, we've added salt. We let the pork cook a little more till we get it all cooked. Our tofu's ready. The next thing I'm gonna add, we'll be adding the goya.
Yep.
The bitter melon. We ready?
Ready.
Okay, here we go. Goya in.
Yay.
Now. About a couple minutes, 3 minutes max.
Okay.
Because, you know, you still want it to be nice and, you know, al dente, not mushy. What's the word you'd use in Okinawa, mushy?
It's al dente.
Al dente is chodo I.
Chodo I. Chodo I. Okay, so we have some flavor now. We can, huh? You want to put your dashi in there? Just like that. I mean, no, I'm just saying, just like that.
Yeah.
Not liquidy. So it'll be nice and dry. Whew, it's going to be good. What do you think?
Oishii. Oishii. I think we can put the tofu.
Okay, tofu going in. Right there, John. Beautiful. Wow.
You can smell that dashi, hondashi, huh?
Yeah, this hondashi smell good, huh?
Yeah.
A little more pepper?
I would. I like black pepper.
Pepper?
Yeah. Go down low, John. Okay. I would also, maybe squishy salt?
No? Yeah.
Oh, John, that's a lot, huh? I mean, give me more.
Did I put too much in the
No.
Too
little? Okay. How you say mix in Okinawan?
Kacha kacha.
Huh?
Kacha kacha.
Kacha kacha.
Kacha kacha. Kacha kacha.
No, it was just two.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay, now eggs, huh?
Yep.
What, right on top?
Right all over.
All over the place. Oh, yeah. So Okinawans used the eggs to get all the good flavors in the wok to stick to the meat and the goya and whatever, because they were, you know, Okinawa was a poor place, so they want to make sure they get every last drop off of that pan, you know?
Flavor, yeah. No, you did a good, you cooked all the three dishes today.
I did, thank you.
That was a weak thank you. You said, thank you, Sam.
Thank you, Uncle Sam and Chef Grant. You guys are amazing. Okay.
Plate right here. Oh. Look at that.
Wow. See all those Okinawans out there, they're mouth salivating right now. Yeah?
Woo-hoo.
Chef?
Yes.
Chef?
Yes. Yes. Yes, John?
It's time to grind.
Let's go. So Grant, your first two dishes.
Yeah, so our first dish was that Mukuji Andagi.
Mukuji Andagi. That's this guy.
Yeah.
Which is
right.
Super good. Buddy.
Very good. And it's savory.
Yeah.
I love it.
Everybody thinks that purple potato is gotta be sweet, but this is a savory, savory style of andagi or tempura. Yeah.
Yeah, very.
And then our second dish was that Okinawa yakisoba using Okinawa soba noodles.
Which is really, really good.
I'm glad you enjoyed it.
Yeah.
The sun noodle makes a big difference.
Yeah.
And you know, you got local ingredients in there, and the bean sprout is crunchy.
Well.
On our third dish, we did the Goya Champuru, the bitter melon with the pork, fried tofu, was very important to brown the tofu, and then the dashi, and then of course the scrambled eggs, that was kind of like the binder to clean up all the flavors in the pan. Right, Grant?
Right.
We didn't need to use the pork, but I would like to ask you, Chef, the significance of pork in the Okinawan diet. Can you tell
well,
me about it?
Okay, I mean, pork was something that was always used in Okinawa, you know, and so when they immigrated to Hawaii, most of the Okinawan people became raised pigs and you know, sometimes they're even teased for that. But, you know, it's a staple of the Uchinanchu or Okinawan people, you know.
I'm glad.
Yeah. Most of the time, Okinawan people, when you say andagi, you automatically think it's going to be sweet.
Right.
But actually, andagi, all it means is tempura.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I also liked your honesty about the purple Okinawan sweet potato.
Ube.
Yeah, ube. When you said straight off the bat, you were told in Okinawa that that's from the Philippines.
And even Goya, certain places in Okinawa, they hardly eat Goya, you know? That was really consumed on the main island of Okinawa. So I have a friend that said, I didn't eat Goya when I was a little kid. So I guess it's where you're from too, part of the island you're from too. So,
Chef, thanks for having us down. I appreciate it. Learned a little bit about the Okinawan meals that we cook today, and I really appreciate you inviting us over.
Thank you. I love cooking with you guys.
But remember,
when Sam Choi's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking. Chef Sam Choi, no cowboy. Please come by house, look my icebox. Our food is complimentary. And please bring John Canary.
Well, what else we got?
We got the eggplant.
Eggplant.
Now, there's several things you can do to the eggplant.
Bitter melon.
Eggplant.
Oh, sorry. Goya, Goya.
And cut.